In this section, we will be performing load flow analysis on Etap. So before getting into Etap, I would like to discuss some of the terminologies used for load flow analysis and why load flow analysis is done. Let's go through a brief theory. What is load flow? Load flow is the solution for the entire power system, which is under consideration. So that's it. And why we are using load flow? In order to compute the voltages, phase angles, real and reactive power flowing into every line. And why are we doing this is to design a substation or design a power system. So after doing a load flow, we get the current flowing through every line, every node, and based on that current, we can then select the suitable cables, suitable transmission line conductors, suitable insulators, and the circuit breaker ratings, and so on. So load flow is an important analyzing tool that is used to design our components used for power systems. And how we will do the load flow is by using these iterative techniques. So we have the Gauss Seidel method, Newton Raphson method, and fast decoupled method. There are also other methods. These are classified based on the speed of convergence to a solution. So since these are iterative solutions, then we have to get a faster rate of convergence to quickly come up with a solution. Fast decoupled method has a greater rate of convergence compared to the Newton-Raphson and with the Gauss Seidel method. Next, we will look at some of the terminologies used for the load flow. In the load flow analysis, we are classifying buses as three. So let me go to the first one, is the load bus. For the load bus, is any bus where the load is being connected. So the real and reactive power are drawn from the supply. This is also called as the PQ bus. The voltage and phase angles are unknown, but we know the real and reactive power of the load bus. And the next one will be the generator bus. And for the generator bus, this is also known as the PV bus. So the real power and the voltages are known, and the reactive power limit is also known from the capability curves. So the phase angle and the reactive power is to be determined using the load flow analysis. And the next one is called the slack bus. This is also known as the swing bus or the reference bus. There will be only a single slack bus. So there will be a single voltage and phase angle. So the voltage and the phase angle are known. The voltage we usually provide will be 1 or 100% and the phase angle will be 0. And all the other values will be computed based on this reference value. Next, we will get into Etap and we will understand better after doing a load flow analysis.